Our last speaker for this evening. Is that our last speaker? Number four? Yes, yes. Are you still alive? Yes. Get up for SK.
Can I not use the mic?
You don't use mic.
Yeah.
You have a project.
Okay.
Can you guys hear me?
I just don't want to use the mic. Is that fine?
I think the guys up there can't hear you, right?
Oh shit.
Okay, cool.
Your thing is here.
Oh, right. So if I want to play, I press next to you.
Left, next, yes.
So you didn't want to play?
I hope so.
Okay.
Okay. I'll turn on the speaker.
Come.
Okay guys, I'm SK. This is a new website that we are launching soon. But then I'm not going to talk about that. I'm going to talk about the book. If you guys want to know more about what's happening here, just come and talk to me next. Okay. Hey bro, you didn't install the fauna.
Don't lie
like this, bro. Okay, never mind. It's okay. It's okay. Let's just continue.
So,
okay, so I'm SK. I think many of you know the story behind my name, but then I'm just gonna talk about that because everybody's tend to ask me why SK. So my whole name is Sathivelu Kunashekaran, a very long Indian name. It's supposed to be some royal name, but then, bro, okay, D. Wuhan. Okay, so my whole name is Sathivelu Kunashekaran, very long name, no one can pronounce it right, never get my mails because no one can spell the name right. So I was like, cool, I'm gonna find something short, so I ended up with SK. Okay, and it kind of sounds like I'm saying sexy, but I was like, okay, cool, let me just stick with that. So the book that we're gonna talk about today is called 4-Hour Work Week by Tim Ferriss. This guy is one of those that go out and do some crazy stuff, and then put it out there like, oh, I did this, so you guys should try this. So a lot of stuff that he says, it sounds like a fantasy and something that we cannot really try to shoot for. We are not in that particular mode. But then by reading this book, I did pick up some of tips that he provided and I followed it. Not all, because his book is one of those books that you feel like it's a capture-all book. Meaning that he'll talk about from A to Z and he'll tell you how to do everything and you feel like, oh, so much stuff to do, I don't know what to do, and just leave the book behind. Something like that's what normally happens. But then, when we created this particular box, he has three different books. So we created a box around him, it's called the Tim Ferriss box. So we promised him that whenever I'm going to talk about one of his books, I have to show the trailers of the other books. So it's just a very 1 minute trailer, so just let's watch it. So who's Tim? This is the answer. Is he going to play? Yes, okay. Bro, sound? Okay. Okay. In this book, it talked about how to push your body, whatever you think you can do, how to go to the next level and do it in an easy manner. And then he got another book, it's called The 4-Hour Chef. So this is the trailer for that book. This book is really interesting, okay? Sorry, team. I'm just going to continue. But then this whole thing start. Oh no. Okay.
It's not working.
But I can see. Oh, okay, now it's back.
Okay. So the whole thing started with him writing a book called 4-Hour Work Week, where he realized how to actually do stuff in an easy manner and also be happy at the end of the day. Because I read this book when I was working for an investment firm, and I was working like from 8 o'clock morning till like probably 4 o'clock, and I go back, shower, and go back to work. So I picked up this book, and life was super hard. I was just working, no girlfriend, not getting laid, whatever. Okay? So this book is one of those books that actually helped me to come out with that kind of mentality. And I only picked up several key points, and I just made sure that I follow those. I didn't do the whole book because it's super hard to do everything. Because he talks about traveling, he talks about productivity, he talks about everything, so it's super hard. Okay? So these are the 8 things that I did follow and kind of work for me. So the first tip is, do not answer calls from unrecognized phone numbers. I do this all the time, especially when I'm talking to people or I'm in a meeting. Because it's one, it's going to interrupt whatever I'm doing. Second is, if I don't really know the person, I don't really feel the need to actually pick up the phone and answer. Okay? But I went a step beyond this. What I did was, my family members, they have a different ringtone. So I would know that, oh, this is my family, so I have to pick up this. Doesn't matter whatever is happening. And then colleagues and all that, they will have a different number, different tone. And then if people that I don't really like, but I have their number, I have a different tone. So I know that I would pick up these numbers before that numbers. So I segregated in that way. So I brought it to the next level, I would say. Next is this. Do not email first thing in the morning or last thing at night. Okay, this actually was killing me. Because when I wake up in the morning, I'll be like, got 17 mails from my boss, another 18 from whoever, and all that. So what I did was, when I wake up, I'm not going to look at my email. I'm just going to look at things that I do want to achieve today. That's it. So I have like 3 or 4 things I want to do. And I'll start with thinking about that instead of just replying mails. And also, I stop replying to mails after like 12 o'clock. Because what happens is, right, when I reply someone after 12 o'clock, they'll reply me back in 1 or 2 minutes, and I have to continue replying, you know. Okay, so it starts this whole thread going. So what I did was I just stopped replying people after 12 o'clock. And if people do want to reach me, now they know that. All you have to do is just call me if it's after 12 o'clock, because they already got into that particular...
Midnight.
Noon, I'm still reachable. Okay? So just make sure you're not doing this. If there's anything that you guys want to follow today, just try this. This really works. Because when you wake up in the morning, it sets you in the right tone, not just replying emails, but then thinking about what you do want to achieve in that particular day. Next is this. Do not agree to meetings or calls with no clear agenda or end time. So the clear agenda bit, I can say, no, okay, it's fine, you don't have agenda. But then I always want to know when that meeting will finish. Because if you tell me like the meeting gonna last for 45 minutes, in my mind I know, okay, this is the kind of thing you'll be talking about. If you tell me the meeting gonna finish 4 hours, most probably I'm gonna say no. So I can see like what kind of things you have in mind. If you tell me it's 10 minutes, it's gonna be one of the productive ones, I'm cool. Okay? Like I was talking to Harinder about it, he said he does not mind about end time, but then he needs an agenda going for the meeting. Why is that so, Hari? Right, so what he does, yeah, he does the reverse of what I'm doing. So he look at the agenda and he will determine, okay, I want to talk about B, C, and D. I don't care about E and F. So he will make sure he talks about it first and spends more time doing it. So it's the reverse of what I'm doing. But either one is one of these are cool. Okay, and then next one is GTP. So you guys have heard about GTDs, getting things done. But GTP is getting to the point. So the idea what he said in the book is you got a GTP to get to GTD. So if you see in a meeting, it follows from the earlier point. People are just rambling, they're just taking up time. Just tell them to get to point. Next is this one. Do not over communicate with low profit, high maintenance customers. So the idea is this. If you look at your whole spectrum of customers, then you're gonna have like 20 to 30% that's gonna pay you a lot of money, no complaints, they're happy with you, you're happy with them. If you upsell them, they're gonna buy it because they love you. And then you got 70% that's like nagging all the time, like your grandma and all that, okay? And then they are always asking more and more and more and more, and they're never happy. So what he's talking about here is, segregate them into 2 different markets. Make sure you spend 80% of your time working with the people who are actually paying you, loving you, talking about you. And they spend 20% time. If this guy's saying, okay, I don't like you, I'm going to find someone else, you just have to say thank you and just leave because you don't really want to serve him anyway. So that's the kind of mentality that I actually got from this book. Next one is do not work more to fix overwhelm. Meaning that as you get more work and work, more and more work, you shouldn't be working more. You should find out what you really want to do and how to delegate others. Okay, this is where I found the whole outsourcing thing. About 2 years back, I found ODAS and Fiverr and all that. So what happened was, as I get more and more work, I started outsourcing more and more out. And I realized that I end up doing stuff that I really like, and the stuff that I didn't like, someone else was doing it for me. So life became better. Okay? And the last one is this. This is very important. So if you guys want to try to do something better next year, try this. Do not expect work to fill a void that non-work relationship and activities should. So this is something that took me super long time to learn. So what happens here is, right, when we hang out with people that we work with, when we hang out with people that we work with, and then we spend so much time with them, the only thing we know is our colleagues, and then the only thing they know is like, okay, SK or whatnot, and then we end up spending so much time with them that we do not know what's happening outside. And this actually happened to me while I was working in one of the banks in Malaysia. So when I actually got out of that circle, right, for about 1 month, I don't know what to do. I had no idea where to go and where people are and, like, you know, where's the coolest place to be and all that, because I always hang out with that particular crowd. Okay? And then it took me 1 month to kind of get back into civilization, let's put it that way. Okay? So if you guys have something planned on for next year, keep this in mind. Try to find different circles and then try to get into that particular circle. Like I'm not a coder, I'm not a designer, I'm not a programmer, whatnot. But then I'm talking to you guys because I do not want to repeat the same mistake. I do not want to spend time in investment bankers and who not. So that's why I'm here. Okay, so try to do this with whatever you guys are doing.
Yeah, I'm an investment banker.
Okay, yeah, he was in Maybank, man. So this is super important. Try to do this next year. And I hope the best for you guys in 2014, okay?